Once upon a time, there was a great rabbi, and this rabbi had two wonderful daughters. Everyone in the community loved their rabbi, and nobody loved him more than his own children. The rabbi would look proudly out at the congregation during services and see his daughters sitting in the sanctuary singing along with the prayers, even the hard ones with a lot of Hebrew. But then, one Shabbat, as the rabbi was giving the kind of sermon where everyone hung on his every word, he noticed that his younger daughter had taken a seat in the back of the congregation. Well, that surprised him, but when the service ended, she was back with her sister in their usual row near the front, so he shrugged his shoulders and didn't think anything more about it. The next week, as the rabbi was leading services, he again spotted his younger daughter way in the back of the balcony, actually in the very last row of the balcony. He thought that perhaps he should say something to her about it, but then in the hubbub and the excitement of the Oneg Shabbat, he forgot all about it. Well, then, the following week, when the rabbi looked out at the congregation during his sermon, his daughter was nowhere to be seen. He couldn't find her anywhere. This almost caused him to lose his place while giving the sermon. But at the end of the service, there she was, singing Adon Olam loudly and joyfully. After services this time, the rabbi just had to ask. "My daughter," he said, "I've noticed that you weren't in the sanctuary during my sermon. Is everything okay?" "Oh yes, Abba," she said, "everything is great." "Well," he asked, "is it that you don't like my sermons?" "Oh no, Abba, I love your sermons. It's just that I had something so important that I just had to do." And she ran off to play as the rabbi stood there wondering, "More important? What could be so important?" Well, it went on like this for the next 3 weeks. The younger daughter disappearing and reappearing during services until finally the rabbi's curiosity became unbearable. So the next Shabbat, when it was the time when he usually delivered his sermon, the rabbi had his director of lifelong learning tell a story instead. The rabbi snuck out of the side door of the sanctuary where he spotted his daughter making her way to a large wooded park not far from the sanctuary. The rabbi followed his daughter into the park, being careful not to be observed, and he watched her as she made her way to a secluded area amidst a small grove of trees, amidst beautiful flowers and bright green grass. The rabbi became a little bit worried, actually, because he knew the park could be a dangerous place for a child on her own, and he wondered, what could she be doing here in the park by herself? As the rabbi watched, his daughter took out a prayer book, and to his amazement, she began to sing the Shema with great intensity and passion. "Hear, O Israel, Adonai, our God, Adonai is one," she prayed. The rabbi could hold back no longer. "My daughter," he cried out, "I hope you will not think it wrong of me, but I just have to know, what exactly is it that you are doing?" "Abba," she said in a surprised voice, "what does it look like I'm doing?" To be honest, this was perhaps a little bit sassy of her. "Well," said the rabbi, "it looks to me like you are saying the Shema, just like we say in the synagogue." "Oh, that's exactly what I'm doing," she replied. "I came here to the park to talk to God." "But my daughter," the rabbi said, "don't you know that the Shema is the prayer that teaches us that God is one?" "Of course I know that, Abba," she said. "I'm in third grade." "But my daughter, don't you know that if God is one, that means that God is the same everywhere? You can talk to God in the sanctuary. You don't have to come to the park." "Abba," she said, "I know that I can talk to God everywhere. I know that God is the same everywhere. But Abba, I'm not the same everywhere." And the rabbi looked around and saw all the trees and flowers and the children playing. And the rabbi asked, "My daughter, do you come to the park to talk to God because it is so beautiful? Is that why you are different here? And his daughter said, Abba, it is beautiful. And our sanctuary is beautiful too. But Abba, that's not why I come here. Look at those children playing. Do you see that woman napping on the bench next to them? That's their mom. She's been working all night and is soon heading off to a second job. And you see that fellow sleeping on the grass? I don't think he has a home. He's here every time I come to the park. I come here to remember that God is everywhere, here with these people in the park, just like God is with all of us in the synagogue. When I am here, I remember how our God is the God for everyone. And I don't know if the rabbi learned something new from his daughter that day, or maybe the rabbi already knew it, but one thing I do know is that we here at Temple Emanu-El, we know how right the rabbi's daughter was, because we find God when we're here in the sanctuary, or when we're singing hallelujah at a family service in the Bethel Chapel, or at the daily service in the Greenwald Chapel. We find God when we study the words of Torah with our dedicated religious school teachers and in the I Am Wise kitchen, when we make meals for the Sunday lunch program. We find God on our family and striker trips to Israel, whether we're at the Western Wall or we're at the Dead Sea. And we find God when we're knitting the warm scarves and sweaters that this very evening our teens will bring on their midnight run to cold and hungry people in our public parks. And so I invite all of you to join with me and say together the watchword of our faith, the most important lesson of the Torah, the Shema. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Hear, O Israel, Adonai is our God, Adonai is one. Shabbat Shalom.